manufacturing is a huge issue to transition what we found in the lab to the society. And in my lab, we're mainly a materials lab, so we work on the fundamental mechanisms and of the reactions and to explore the fundamental potential of materials. But we've also put significant effort in making a larger batch of material. So generally, to understand materials, you only need grams of the material. But to be able to move into the realm of manufacturing, we often need to transition to 100 grams or even kilogram scale production. And that is quite a challenge in a university setting. But we've been doing our best to work with graduate student postdocs and also collaborate with industry to scale up the fabrication and testing. For example, we strive to make not only full cell batteries in the coin cell format, but also we are making, let's say, 5 ampere hour pouch cell, which one can basically power a cell phone. So this is sort of a prototyping process, which is very important to demonstrate that the nanomaterials indeed has a potential to be used in you know, human scale applications. But we've also worked on small scale things. For example, we have a project on small batteries that may be used for very small devices that can be called magic dust, and you can use it in the Internet of Things. So these are devices which integrate logic with photovoltaics with energy storage together, and you can print them and they would communicate with each other. So these are combining sensors and computing and energy together into a single package. So those are batteries which are micron scale or even sub-micron scale. And we have done some of the leading work. In 2010, we actually made a battery made of a single nanowire, which is just a few hundred nanometers in size. And that was the smallest battery in the world, which is actually smaller than the mitochondria in the cell, which is the energy unit in biology. So the smallest capillary in the human is 2 microns. So you need to have units which are micron size. And so nowadays, the limitation is not in logic. We can easily make tens of thousands of transistors, which can function, you know, in a micron scale package. But what is really needed is actually energy storage, and these could be used for example, securing nuclear materials. So these could be used for tracking the life cycle of materials as they were used in the industry. These sensors and memories and energy storage units, they could be used to monitor structure integrity of bridges of plants. So these could be very useful for manufacturing as well.